Welcome back. Now, he's known as the King of the Waltz. He plays a violin that dates back to 1667, and he wants to bring people together across the world with his concerts. We are talking about André Rieu.
Yes, André has his own orchestra of 50 musicians, and his live shows always impress audiences with dramatic staging and costumes. André's here this morning.
Very good morning.
We're going to give people a flavour first.
OK.
Let's have a look.
That's fantastic, André. Just tell us first, before we talked about other things, about that place. It was a village, wasn't it?
Yeah, in Cortona, in Tuscany.
And you took over, it looks like you took over the whole village.
I went there and I said, this is the place. But, you know, the square was steep like this. And I said, and everybody said, no, do it on the other square. But I said, no, this is so romantic. And then my son Pierre, he had to build the whole thing, and it's uphill, so everything.
So you must be a bit of a nightmare for your team, are you? Because you go around the world, you pick beautiful places, and this, we'll do it here.
There and not there.
Your concerts are known for being extremely dramatic. I mean, what's your favourite one, and which was the most dramatic, do you think?
I think it was the idea of copying the Schönbrunn Castle in Vienna.
And this was done in your own, where you live, was it?
No. I mean, we copied.
Oh, you copied the castle?
We copied the castle.
Okay.
Pierre did. One to one.
Oh, and so
we brought it all over the world.
Oh, my goodness. And do you take it around the world?
Yeah. We took it around the world. Oh.
I suppose one of the things that you brought to, I don't know what you call it, the way you orchestrate things, is scale. The size of the
production. Not always. I mean, okay, the orchestra is a normal orchestra, 60 people, and we play in normal arenas. But at that time, We were playing in front of the Schönbrunn Castle, and I said to Pierre, this is so fantastic. The music, the castle, Strauss, the dancers, the ice skaters. Let's copy it and bring it to... At that time, we went to Australia, so I brought it to Australia.
Oh, as you do. And we should say Pierre, your son, is standing just behind the camera, so that's why you keep referring to him. You've got a new album out called Magic of the Movies.
Yeah.
I mean, movies and music are so much part of each other, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
How did you choose what you were going to play?
With my heart.
Yeah.
I mean, this Godfather song, the Titanic, what is it? I don't know the album by heart, but it's all movie.
Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Yeah, music that touches my heart. And when it touches my heart, I know it will touch your heart.
Have you got a favourite? I mean, is there a movie theme favourite that's one of yours?
I think on this movie, it is the Titanic.
Yeah, all this sweeping. And everyone has I suppose the thing with movie music, along with some classical music, is often people relate it to a time in their lives, don't they?
Yes.
Because it had maybe a moment in time or a stage in their life.
And movie music is very often classical music. A lot of Yo-Yo Ma, he plays very often, and Itzhak Perlman, they play very much in movie.
Interesting. So your son obviously takes part in the stage. You loved the violin from very early on in your life. Are you sad that he hasn't done that?
No, not at all. I mean, he plays the trumpet and he wants to play more, but he has to work so much for me.
He's got to build the stage first.
Yes.
tell us a little bit about your violin. I think last time we saw it. It's very, very special.
Yes, it is very special. It's anyhow very special to be able to play on a Stradivari. And every time I took it out of the case, I'm so happy that I can play on it. I feel myself as the caretaker. I own it, but I will take care that next generation can play on it.
Because that's what you'll have to do. It will eventually be passed on. Because
of course.
How many people have owned it? Do you even know how many people have actually owned
it? A lot of people. All over the world. Mm. And so that's what I say. I hope that next generation... The violin I had last time in your show is now to Korea.
Oh, really?
A little Korean girl. Because it was a little bit too small. It was his second violin. from, as you said, from 1667. And now I have a Stradivarius from 1732.
Okay.
It's one of his last violins.
So a whole 50 years later.
Yeah, it's incredible. He made violins his whole life.
And you're evangelical about young people taking up instruments, aren't you? You want children to take up classical music. The violin's a tricky one on that first attempt, isn't it? Because it never sounds good first time.
I just gave my two little grandchildren, Pierre's children, two violins.
How old are they?
Three. Twins.
Three.
And you see them, it gives me tears in my eyes.
Oh, it's lovely to see you again. Thank you. Thank you very much. Andre's album, Magic of the Movies, is out on the 5th of November. And his UK tour starts on December the 10th at the Odyssey Arena in Belfast. You're playing in Manchester as well, aren't you?
Yes, in Manchester and in Birmingham, extra concerts.
Brilliant.
Yeah. And thank you. Home for Christmas concert in Maastricht. That's going to be screened live in cinemas all over the UK, November the 24th.
That
well.
Is.